This video is sponsored by Lomi. For decades, hydrogen power has held enormous promise as an alternative to fossil fuels. After all, who wouldn't want an energy source made from the most abundant element in the universe, whose only byproduct is water? Yet here we are in 2022, and hydrogen still hasn't lived up to its potential. But a new hydrogen breakthrough may finally give this promising fuel source its chance to shine. Even though it may not look particularly pretty, this innovative hydrogen paste boasts energy densities that give lithium-ion batteries a serious run for their money. Will we soon see this goop powering cars, planes, the grid? Let's dive in. As a fuel source, hydrogen is sort of like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. It has many attractive features. For one, it's the most abundant element in the universe, ranking number one on the periodic table. Well, that isn't because of the abundance, it's just the first element with an atomic weight of one. Anyway, you get my point. And this matters because when it comes to sustainable energy, resource availability is a pretty critical factor. Lithium, for example, is the 33rd most abundant element. But not only is hydrogen incredibly abundant, with a small caveat which we'll get into in a bit, it's also incredibly clean. As fuel in an electrochemical process, it combines with oxygen, producing electricity, leaving nothing but pure water as a byproduct. But hydrogen has a dark side too. First, while it is indeed the most abundant element in the universe, in its purest form, it tends to drift off planet and into space. The hydrogen that gets left here on Earth tends to form very strong bonds with other elements. There are a few ways to extract pure hydrogen, but this is where the green footprint tends to get a bit muddy. One of the most popular methods of extracting hydrogen is called steam methane reforming, essentially burning methane gas at high pressures and temperatures to separate the hydrogen from the carbon elements. There are two main problems here. The first is that the process itself is very energy intensive. And two, the end result still produces carbon emissions. Yeah, not looking so hot after all. The greener method for extracting hydrogen is called electrolysis. This involves running electric currents through water, separating the water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen. The problem here is that it still requires loads of electricity and tons of water. Studies revealed that electrolysis loses about 30% of its energy from the splitting process itself, then another 26% from transporting the hydrogen in the fuel station, leaving only about half the initial energy before the hydrogen even makes its way into your vehicle. Then there's transportation. Hydrogen typically has to either be stored on site where it's extracted or shipped around in huge pressurized tanks. With no real infrastructure for fueling hydrogen cells, the technology just hasn't taken off as some have anticipated. We've covered more about the drawbacks of hydrogen in previous videos, which you can check out here. But hydrogen may still have its moment to shine thanks to this. Yeah, it may not look pretty, but according to its creators at the Fraunhofer Institute in Germany, this gray goop may solve many of hydrogen power's biggest issues. It's called power paste, and it's made by combining hydrogen and magnesium with metal salts and a compound called ester, formed by a reaction between alcohol and acid. The two elements are combined at around 662 degrees Fahrenheit at 5 to 6 times atmospheric pressures to form magnesium hydride. But before I tell you about this breakthrough compound, I have to tell you about the most remarkable little appliance I've seen in years. This is Lomi, a ridiculously cool, beautiful kitchen electric composter. If you do any amount of cooking, I'm sure you're familiar with this. Food scraps from vegetables, fruit, even coffee grounds and eggshells. This isn't trash, it's the basis for future plant food. But usually it takes months to break down. But with Lomi, you can take this and turn it into nutrient-rich dirt in just hours. Using Lomi twice a week can reduce your waste footprint by 50%. It has three modes, an eco mode, which uses just around 1 kilowatt hour of energy, and takes 3 to 5 hours. Use grow mode, and in 16 to 20 hours, you have nutrient-rich dirt that's perfect to turn back around and add to a garden or a houseplant. There's even a Lomi-approved mode, which can break down Lomi-approved bioplastics. Whether you live in a small studio apartment or a farm, convert your food scraps quickly into dirt with Lomi. I've had mine for over a month, and I still get a kick out of seeing the results every morning. Use my link, links.pella.earth/2bit, to check out this revolutionary new product today. Huge thanks to Lomi and to you for supporting the companies that support the show. The result is this energy-dense gray goop, which the company says could be easily stored and shipped inside cartridges at room temperatures and remain completely stable until it reaches about 482 degrees Fahrenheit, about 250 degrees Celsius. So no need to worry about fuel cells exploding in a parking lot on a hot summer day. Pretty cool. To release the energy, a plunger releases the paste into a chamber where it reacts with water at a controlled rate, where it's then converted into electricity around a proton exchange membrane. One major benefit of the technology is that it resolves the storage and transportation issue. The paste boasts an energy density equal to a 700 bar tank of hydrogen of the same weight. This cartridge system could also make refueling much more practical. The developers imagine drivers simply being able to pull out into a service station and swapping out their old cartridge for a new one. They even suggest that power paste could be supplied via standard fuel lines with relatively inexpensive equipment. But what really makes this a huge breakthrough, though, is its energy density. Power paste has a specific energy around 10 times greater than lithium-ion batteries. What would that look like in the real world? A long-range Tesla Model 3 battery weighs around 1,060 pounds with a capacity of roughly 75 kilowatt hours, which has a usable range of about 300 miles. A traditional 8.5-gallon hydrogen fuel tank typically carries enough fuel for about 400 miles of range, weighing roughly about 76 pounds. A cartridge of the same weight using power paste could theoretically push your range to about 3,000 kilometers. That would take you from San Diego to Seattle and still leave you with 1,000 more kilometers remaining. For the average commuter, that would mean needing to fuel about one time a month. Now, while power paste boasts really high energy density, it stumbles a bit when it comes to efficiency. Kind of like gasoline, actually. Lithium-ion batteries are the efficiency champions, running at around 95% efficiency, meaning nearly every kilowatt hour stored in the battery gets converted into usable energy moving your car forward. Gasoline is notoriously inefficient, at around 17 to 35% efficiency. So after factoring in the chemical transformations and waste heat, you're only using less than a third of your tank to move your car. Traditional hydrogen fuel sits at around 60% efficiency. How does power paste stack up? Right now, the developers say it maintains an efficiency rate of about 50%, which is significantly higher than gasoline, but still quite a bit behind lithium-ion batteries and traditional hydrogen fuel cells. So is that case closed on the economic viability of power paste? Well, what does the data say? So let's say it takes around 80 kilowatt hours to fully charge a 75 kilowatt hour battery. There can be some energy leakage and other inefficiencies. Right now, at the time of this video in San Diego, electricity costs roughly 34 cents per kilowatt hour. So roughly $28 to fully charge your Tesla, assuming you don't have home solar or off-rate time of use billing periods. So $28, about 271 miles, that comes in at around 10 cents per mile. With the average daily commute in America sitting around 41 miles, you need to fully charge roughly four times in a month, bringing that total monthly cost to about $112. Hydrogen fuel costs roughly $16 a gallon here in San Diego. So our 8.5-gallon tank costs about $130 to fill up. If you can go about 400 miles, $130, that comes out to roughly 33 cents per mile. So now let's take a look at a power paste fuel cell, which remember has 10 times the energy density of the lithium-ion battery, which means our similarly weighted fuel cell gives us 475 kilowatt hours of sweet gray goop under the hood. As of this video, there are no hard numbers on how much these fuel cartridges would cost, let alone service fees or anything else. But let's assume for now that the cost per kilowatt hour is comparable to the cost of residential energy, 35 cents per kilowatt hour. So this swap now costs about $166, but remember, the paste only has a 50% efficiency rating. So that 475 kilowatt hours, we end up actually only getting about 237 kilowatt hours worth of usable energy. If 75 kilowatt hours got us 437 kilometers of distance, about 6.7 kilometers per kilowatt hour, then even at 50% efficiency, the power paste can take us 1600 kilometers, which still comes out to about 10 cents per kilometer, which is about half the cost of traditional hydrogen, but still twice as much as lithium ion. So yeah, as of right now, EVs still make way more sense for the typical consumer. Not only is electricity cheaper, even with historically high prices, it's still plentiful. And don't forget, with a battery EV, you can just recharge at home. And if you use home solar, you can basically eliminate the cost of refueling altogether. While hydrogen is abundant, to refuel your car would still require swapping out your old cartridge for a new one, meaning you'd have to be someone's customer. Beholden to prices and supply chain issues, which we all know can be a huge problem. EVs just don't face that problem. Even with 10 times less range, EVs will still come out on top for most average consumers. So maybe the average commuter car will continue to be a battery electric and not hydrogen. But what about other major CO2 emitters like airplanes, where weight is a bigger factor than cost? Aerial vehicles could be a potential application. Since current battery technology is far too heavy for planes to use and still maintain efficiency and cost effectiveness, using power pace with higher energy densities could still make sense. If it's lighter than batteries and cheaper than standard fossil fuel, it would be a win-win. In fact, the developers of PowerPaste see a future in which their lightweight, energy-dense sludge could power things like drones, underwater vehicles, medical devices, and portable outdoor camping equipment or backup generators. But the two biggest applications, I think, would be aircraft and large cargo shipping vessels, which both currently use a lot of petroleum and don't have an equivalent yet in the battery world. Then there's possible grid-level applications as well. Say an offshore wind farm with a steady supply of seawater to refuel electric ships. Now, there are still a handful of questions surrounding power paste. Namely, what happens to the byproducts? After all, since we're no longer using pure hydrogen, we no longer get pure water at the end. It's possible that the leftover magnesium and metal salts could be recycled, though that would involve developing some kind of infrastructure that doesn't exist yet. How economically viable is it to produce the paste? Is it environmentally friendly? So the production, recycling, life cycle questions, I think, are one of the big things that I'm thinking about that remain unanswered. Will power paste finally allow hydrogen energy to catch up to battery technology? Or is it yet another pipe dream? Should we even be looking into hydrogen breakthroughs at all, especially with more and more advanced battery technology proving to be so efficient? Sound off in the comments below. All right, that's a look at this cool new breakthrough. Hydrogen is one of those things I want to love, but there's so many challenges with it. Being so small, being so tiny and abundant, it's very hard to keep and compress, but this paste does seem pretty promising. It would solve a lot of the problems that I think hydrogen has been plagued with for years, for decades, really. But what do you guys think? Check our other videos. We have some other stuff we think you're going to love. And as always, I'm Ricky with Tuba Da Vinci, and we'll catch you guys next week.